Hey, what's up guys? I finally decided to install the Linux Bazzite distro on the LiX in a dual OS setup alongside Windows 11. In this video, we'll go step by step through the installation process, and in later videos, we'll explore other customization, tweaks, and benchmark comparisons for you to know which OS is more optimized for gaming. But for now, let's focus on the installation process. So let's get started. First, head over to the Bazzite website and download the image. When you click download, it will ask about the hardware you plan to install it on. There are several options including Steam Deck, Lenovo Legion Go, GPD, etc. There's also specified option for Ally and Ally X, so we'll choose that. Next, it will ask about the desktop environment you prefer. KDE is more customizable and support extensive configuration possibilities, while GNOME focus on a clean UI for a more user-friendly and Mac OS-like experience. There are other desktop environments heading our way. Personally, I'm going with KDE, and it also says here it's what Steam OS use, but you can pick whatever you prefer. I may make a separate video comparing this environment, but for now, we'll stick with KDE. Next, I'll use the MiniTool partition wizard to create partitions on my Ally X storage drive. When you get the Ally X, it ships with a 1TB drive in a single partition. To set up dual OS, we'll need to create another partition. And this tool is great for that. As you can see, our C drive is currently at full 1TB capacity. However, when I select it, there's no option to create another partition right now. We only see options like delete, format, and copy in the partition management interface. While if we select other partitions, like the recovery one, we see additional options like separate, merge, extend, and resize. The reason we can't separate the C drive is because it has BitLocker encryption enabled. The Ally X ships with this Windows encryption enabled instead of using FAT32 or NFTS formats. To separate this partition, we'll need to temporarily disable BitLocker. An easy way to do this is by pressing Windows plus I on your keyboard or head over to Settings in the Start menu. And then go to Privacy and Security, then Device Encryption. Here you will see that Device Encryption is currently turned on, so we're going to disable it. Now give it some time to decrypt. And once that's done, reload the MiniTool partition wizard. Now, if we check the C drive, its file system will show as NFTS, and the additional options we talked about, like separate partition, will be available. So click on it, and a window will pop up showing the size split between the original and the new partitions. For demonstration purposes, I'll split it exactly in half, but you can adjust it however you prefer. Click OK, and now we see a new D drive created, but we still need to click Apply to confirm those changes. Now, since the partition is currently in use, since we are in Windows, it will schedule the changes for the next restart. Upon restarting, you will see the tool is applying the changes right before booting into Windows. And once it's done, we'll now have two drives, as you can see. But the new partition is still using NFTS file format, while Bazzite requires an X64 file system. So we'll need to format the new partition. Select it, right-click and choose Format. From there, select X64 as the new file system. You can also rename the partition and adjust the cluster size if needed. Click OK, then Apply, and give it a moment to complete. Now that we are done splitting the original partition, we can re-enable Windows disk encryption like it was before. Next, we'll need a USB drive for installing the Bazzite image. Use a USB drive with at least 12GB of space. If the drive is formatted as NFTS, we'll need to reformat it to FAT32, because UEFI specifications mandate that the boot partition to be formatted with FAT32 file system. So right-click on the USB drive, choose Format, select FAT32, and apply the changes. Now, download and install Rufus, which is a free app for creating bootable drives. Open Rufus, select your USB drive, and load the Bazzite image we downloaded earlier. Keep everything to default, such as partition scheme as MPR, the target system as BIOS or UEFI, and the file system as FAT32. Click Start. It will prompt you a warning regarding difference in GRAB versions, since the image uses a non-standardized version of a GRAB 2.12 version than currently installed in Rofus. Just press yes, which will download it. The next message will say that all data present on drive will be deleted. Press yes and Rofus will create the bootable drive with Bazzite image in it. Once that's done, we restart Ally X. And while it's booting, I press the volume up button to open the boot launcher and select the USB drive that has Bazzite in it. We'll see three options: troubleshooting, test and install media, and install Bazzite. Let's select the first option. The installation process begins by selecting your language, and before proceeding, you will also need to configure some settings like time and date and move on to the installation destination. Here you will see the available drives. Set the storage configuration to automatic. It will notify you that 17 GB of space is required and display the available space on the drive. Select the Bazzite partition we created earlier. Now press delete and then reclaim the space. Now it should install it on the partition we selected. Next, we can set up network settings like connect to Wi-Fi and create a user with a password. Once everything is configured, the begin installation button will now be clickable. So click on it and give it some time to complete. After installation, when you boot, you will see a menu to select the operating system. However, you might encounter an error like bad shim signature. This happens because secure boot is currently enabled in BIOS. While some Linux distros support secure boot functionality, but it may need to be activated in a later process, so for now, we'll need to disable secure boot to get in. With secure boot disabled, the issue should be resolved. Now that we are in Bazzite, we'll find a welcome page where we can choose language settings. And as you can see, as soon as we have finished, it took us directly to Steam. We can head to desktop mode just like in a Steam Deck. And now that we are in KDE desktop environment, from here we can customize it to the way we like. We can also install additional tools based on your needs. But now, there is an issue with Windows. Since we disabled secure boot, Windows won't boot in unless it's enabled again. To fix this, enable back secure boot and then in Windows, disable BitLocker encryption just like we did earlier. Now with BitLocker off, both operating systems can coexist without requiring secure boot. Of course, we can then enable secure boot to work in Bazzite if we want to have it enabled. Now before wrapping up, I want to highlight some of the other features of the MiniTool partition wizard. It's more than just a tool for splitting and merging drives. You can also recover deleted or lost data, perform quick or full partition recovery scans, benchmark your SSD or HDD for sequential and random read-write speeds, and analyze disk space usage. It also allows you to migrate your OS to another SSD or HDD for backups. There's a surface test to check drive health and spot errors. And if you right-click a partition, you will see options to check and fix data corruption, change file systems, adjust cluster size, and more. While if you select an entire disk, you can convert it between GPT and MPR. The tool also has a bootable media version for use outside of operating system. You can create this bootable version on a USB drive, boot from it, and access the same tools in a specialized environment for tasks like RAID configuration, data recovery, and disk management. In my opinion, MiniTool Partition Wizard is an all-in-one solution for managing your drives. It's great for recovery, benchmarking, and general maintenance tasks. Of course, the method I followed today is just one of many, but I hope you found it useful. I ask you if you enjoyed this video to please give it a like and subscribe to TechOSOR. I'll be uploading more videos about Bazzite, including performance comparisons, optimization tips, and even trying the tightening memory timing tweak we just applied on the Ally X few weeks ago, so stay tuned for that. Thanks for watching and supporting the channel. and I'll see you guys in the next one. Peace out.